In this section, we're going to be covering grids and also isometric grids, and these can be useful for maintaining composition and spacing when you're designing. So how do we see these grids? Well, you could just simply press on Command and apostrophe and it will show one. And if we just start here, I'll just select a rectangle and I will click and drag out like this. And notice how it's snapping. I'll zoom in a little bit more. Notice how it's snapping as I get to the grids. This is because my snapping is turned on up here. And if I click on this, I can go down and say snap to grid, that's selected. And I can snap to baseline grid. That's these other faint lines in between, kind of like a subgrid. So you can select whichever ones you want here, and that helps with designing. So I know that this has fit perfectly in this square here, and I can see it's helping me snap into place. And I can make a copy of that. Let's say I press Command J to power duplicate, and then I move it across so it snaps into the next location. I can press Command J again, and I can see that it perfectly lines up all the way. So this is the simple way of using grids and spacing out. Let's have a look at the other options that we have. So to do that, head on up to View, and then Grid and Axis. So I'm going to click on that. And you see this pop-up box appears. And basically at the top, we've got a couple of presets, one for creating icons, one for isometric. And then we have show grid here. Toggle that on and off. You can see the grid appearing and disappearing. And then we've got pixel grid. And then we have mode. Right now it's on automatic, so it's automatically created this grid to fit our document size. And you can see these gray lines, the grid. If it's a bit hard for you to see, you can just whack up this slider to make it easier on the eye. You can also change the color as well. If I go ahead and click on basic, you can see we just have a basic grid and it says spacing 64. I could change this to 100 if I want, and you can see they get slightly bigger. I'll just leave it on 64 for now. And you see divisions, we just have one at the moment. If I click on 3, and then press return, you can see we have the subgrid underneath, but I'll just leave it on 1 for now. So that's basic. You can set it up the way you want it. And then when I click on advanced, here's where things get quite interesting. We have grid type standard. So that's what it's on right now. I can click through all of these, and these are all kind of presets. So we've got isometric, dimetric, trimetric, and 2-to-1 triangles. So there's all kinds of grids that you can get set up really quickly with and start designing. But if I just leave it on isometric for now, you can go down, and I'm not going to go too far into this. You can customize it the way you want it. On your first axis, second axis, etc., you can create a plane set, and we'll go into that a little bit later. This little pop-up box appears. It's basically the isometric box. This is what we'll be using, but I'll just get rid of that for now. So you can go further into that, but we'll just keep it to the basics for now. And then also you have cube. That's the last one. And basically this allows you to kind of manipulate this cube. So you can see how the grid reacts. So you can customize it to how you like. So this is kind of like left and right, spinning in one place. And if I go here and drag this up and down, I can get kind of a different view. So if you are creating an isometric kind of design, this could be quite useful when you get more advanced. But for now, let's just go on this preset here, which is isometric with planes. So I'm going to click on that and I'll just leave it on that one. Okay, I'll press close. So we're ready to start designing now. But first, I want that isometric box again. So how we get that is we go up, we go to Window, and then we go to Isometric. So here it is, we have it with us now. So let's just go ahead and draw out a box. So I'm going to click on the Rectangle tool, and as my snapping is turned on, I'll just click about here, and I'll just drag out a shape about this big. So why did it draw it with the plane? Well, because this option was selected, Edit in Plane. Let me continue with this. So right now it's on top, so that's why it drew it that way. But if I click on side, let's say front here actually, it changes, the grid changes. So I can go ahead and draw out another one. Let's say I start from here and I click and drag up. It's drawing it as if it's the right side of this cube. I can go ahead and make it slightly darker so it looks like a proper cube. And then let's say I want to do the other side. I can click on side and then click and drag out another box, snap it into place. And then maybe I'll make this one a little bit lighter. And in fact, I'll make the top one a lot lighter. So there we go. I can turn off this grid at this point, just Command apostrophe, and just see what it looks like. So we've just made a cube pretty much. So I'll turn it back on and I'll show you another way we can do it. So I'll just delete those layers. And this time I'll turn off Edit in Plane. So I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to put it back on top. And now I'm just going to draw out a square. So I'll just click and drag out. I'll hold Shift to keep it perfectly square shaped. And then from this point, I can go over and I can click on Fit to Plane. So now that I've clicked it there, I can click on the Move tool and I can just line it up to the grid. You see, it's not perfect because I kind of guessed, but then I could just pull it out and there it is. It fits in place. And I can do that with the side as well. So if I go ahead and draw another one out, let's say like this, I can go over to, let's say, this side. I'll click on that and then I'll click on Fit to Plane. Then I click on the Move tool and I can try and line it up. Oh my God, I got it perfectly right. That's amazing. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, so that's another way of doing it. And of course, there's other options in here. You see, it says like Flip Horizontal in Plane. You can click on that. You can click on Flip Vertical. And you see, like, let me just show you. This is the top of it, as you can see the handle. And if I click on Flip Vertical, you can see it's gone upside down now. So if I had some kind of pattern clipped in here, it might be more obvious. And you can rotate clockwise and anti-clockwise as well. But for now, let's just delete all of that and we'll just try and make some kind of building. So I just want to show you something I created before in it, and that is this one here. So using this same grid, I was able to create this big kind of skyscraper you might find in Miami, just with the windows going around like that. I can turn on the grid so you can see Command apostrophe. You can see how it kind of lines up. In fact, I think I might have used a slightly different grid, but anyway, that's one version. We'll try and create something like that. And then I'll just click off of that. And I'll show you when you get more advanced, you can start creating things like this. So this is something I made in a previous tutorial. You can zoom in really far to look at all the kind of drinks, but this was all done on an isometric grid as well. So I'll just get rid of that for now and we'll start from the beginning. Just make something simple. And by the way, if you do want to change the grid at any point, you don't need to go up here again. You can just click on this grid settings and play around with it from there. So for now, we're going to hit top and we're going to hit edit in plane. And I'm going to select the rectangle tool and I'm just going to drag out a shape that I want. I'm holding down Shift to keep it in a perfect square. That's my first one done. I'll make it light. Now I'll create the side. So I'll just click on side and maybe I'll start from down here. You see, it's kind of lining up because I've got snapping on. Yeah, down here. And I'll click and drag that up and I'll just try and snap it into place. I'll make this slightly darker there and then we'll do the front side. So again, I'll just click and drag down until it snaps into place and I'll make this even darker. Okay, now I want to create those windows that go around here. So I can actually reuse this shape that I've got. So I'm going to press on the Move tool and I'm going to press Command C, Command V. I've made a copy. I'm going to make that lighter. And now I'm just going to drag this down and snapping is going to help me place it into the right place. So I'll just place it about here. We'll make them a lot thicker. And from here, I can just press Command J again and just hold Shift and click and drag that up to the top there. And I can press Command J once more, and that's done. So that's one side of the windows done. I can make my life easier again by just selecting all of those windows, pressing Command C, Command V. I've got a whole load of duplicates now, and I can just go up to Transform and Flip Horizontal. Now I can just move it over to the side like that until it snaps into place. So I'll turn off the grid so we can see what we've made. So Command apostrophe, there we go. I probably need to change the colors of some of these things, but you can see we can make kind of a tall cube building looking thing. And we can start adding doors if we want as well. Let me just make one now, actually. So I'll just turn on my grid again. I'll just copy this window here. I'll hold down Command and click and drag it inwards. I'll change it to, I don't know, let's say a yellow color just so it's obvious for you. And we'll make it really small, actually. And then I'll just drag this down into the middle somewhere, maybe a little bit smaller. And there we go, we have a door. So this is how you design with grids using the isometric grid and this isometric panel. So you can get creative and make something like SimCity. Okay, that's grids and isometric grids.